for the Family Feud Armed Forces Week Special. Introducing the United States Army. Sergeant Carlton Edwards, Sergeant Dale Kwan, Captain John Schaefer, Sergeant Alvina Penda, and Sergeant Steve Murray. Ready for action. Against the United States Navy. Lieutenant Liz Berry, Petty Officer Russ McCamey, Petty Officer George Rodriguez, Petty Officer Julie Harbour, and Petty Officer Craig Roberts. Let's start the Family Feud! With the star of Family Feud, Private Ray Cohn.
Thank you for joining us. Well, I can't believe it. We've got a great week of shows in store for you. We thank you for joining us at home. Hello, Gene Wood.
Hello, Ray Cohn.
Do you feel military?
I certainly do, sir.
You should, and I'm glad you called me sir.
You're welcome, sir.
This week, we're going to have all five branches of the military represented. At the end of the week, we're going to play six shows, all for 6 days. At the end of 5 days, whichever two military branches are ahead will play on the sixth day for the championship. And I can't wait to get this started. For the Army, nope, let's get this right. Army first, Lieutenant Commander Steve. This is wrong. I have the wrong. We have a man that's going to lose his job because it's not Lieutenant Commander Steve Honda. I'm going to walk over and find out myself. Okay. Sergeant Carlton.
Sergeant
with the Army.
Carlton.
Give him a big round of applause.
Yeah!
It's me. Yes.
What is your first name?
My first name is Carlton. My last name is Edwards.
I'm sorry about that. Your
no
first
problem.
Name is Carlton.
Yes.
Your last name is?
Edwards.
Edwards. And you're representing the Army as the captain today?
Yes, I am.
And you're playing for?
For the Army Emergency Relief Fund.
All right.
Yeah.
I wish you well. You're playing against the Navy. Are you ready?
Ready. Oh, we're ready.
Yeah,
it's through.
Ready.
It's over.
Well,
it's over.
To beat you?
Yeah, it's over. Hey, they through. Their ship is sunk.
Their ship is sunk.
That's it. It's over.
Oh, I don't want to cause a civil war here, but say hello to the Navy.
Yeah.
How are you?
Hi, Ray. How are you?
Now, I have no idea what your name is or what your rank is due to the fact that no one has a cue card for me. Your name is Liz, and you could be a general. What are you?
I'm Lieutenant Liz Berry.
Lieutenant
United
Liz Berry, we
yes.
thank you so very much for that. And who are you playing for?
I'm playing for the Navy Relief.
Is your ship sunk?
All right.
Have one thing to say because of the continuing rivalry between the Navy and the Army. We just want to say, beat Army!
Whoa! I say it's time to play the Feud! Let's go! Come on! Come on, Liz. Sergeant, Lieutenant, the first service to $300 is going to get a chance to play for the $5,000 for their charity. Good luck, Army against the Navy. We ask 100 women this question, and the top five answers are on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Remember, we ask 100 women, tell me a sure sign your husband is mad at you. Ooh, Liz.
When he doesn't speak to you.
Let me see. When he doesn't speak to you. It's number one. All right, Sergeant. Here we go. The Navy takes control first. Russ.
How you doing, Ray?
Well, I'll tell you, I couldn't be better because
right.
I'm with the military. I feel
you
safe.
You got that.
Yeah,
you feel safe.
You're with the Navy.
I'm with the Navy. I feel
right.
safe.
Well, how about when you don't get any...
We ask 100 men, women, tell me a sure sign when you know your husband is mad at you. Coming from Sailor Russ, he says no. Does the judge understand that? Oh, the judge does. Okay. Yeah, he does. Okay. This is. Is it? He said he's in the same boat.
Good answer. Yeah.
I'm gonna love this week. Show me. It sounds like an Hawaiian song. No, it's not there. We need a much louder buzz there. Hi, George.
How you doing?
How you doing? We ask 100 women, tell me a sure sign when your husband is mad at you.
Doesn't come home.
Okay. You know, he couldn't.
Good answer.
Doesn't come home.
Yeah.
I don't know, George. He might be out at sea. Let me see. Let me see. He doesn't come home. Two strikes. Army. Think of a steal over there. You're going to get a chance to steal.
All right, come on, Julie.
Julie.
Ray.
Shake my hand.
Sorry, I'm thinking.
Julie, do you love
me? Well, my fiancé was mad at me last night.
He was?
And he wouldn't give me any money this morning.
Money?
Whoa! Well, what does it cost to be your fiancé? I have a few extra bucks. Maybe we could work a deal out. You say dough.
Yeah.
Right. You know they're mad at you when you don't see any De Niro.
Yeah.
Navy, the Army is going to get a chance to steal this bank. If you could, we ask 100 women, tell me a sure sign your husband is mad at you, Steve.
When he goes around the house pouting.
Oh, when he pouts. I hate that.
How do you say your name?
Alvinia.
Alvinia, yes.
When he files for divorce.
Oh, that's a good sign. Honey, it's a little something for you. We're getting divorced. Ron?
When he yells at you.
When he takes the car.
Carlton. Yeah.
Come on, yells at you.
Yeah. I can see a guy. I can't hear you. Show me for the bank when he yells at you. You! Army took it right from the Navy. How was that again?
They're halfway sunk.
Show me. Halfway sunk?
Yeah.
Show me number two. I love this. Face
expression.
Oh, that's usually a woman's move. Number four. Ignore. Number five. Slams the door. We're going to come right back with a lot more fun. So
don't go away.
We were heading up. We are back. Right now, the Army has $64. The Navy has zero. Let's go. It's time. Russ is ready.
I'm ready.
My answers aren't any good, but I'm ready.
I like it, Russ. I like it.
Another one around here.
Russ has got one hand there and the other one just moving for
balance.
The top five answers are on the board. Name something that parents try to talk young couples out of doing.
Russ.
Dating too soon.
How about early dating?
Yeah. Dating too soon. Yeah.
Not fair, Russ. Hold on. Dale, something that parents try to talk young couples out of doing.
Marriage.
Okay, let me see.
Marriage.
Getting married. There you go. Right back there. All right. We've got Schaefer here.
Yes.
And you are?
Captain.
You are a captain.
I am a captain.
Captain Schaefer.
Yes.
Something that parents try to talk young couples out of doing.
Having children too soon.
Yeah, sometimes mom and dad, wait before you have children.
Okay.
Navy says that's a good answer.
Good answer.
Alvinia.
Yes.
I'm ready to enlist.
Come on down.
Come on down.
Can I go too?
What is your assignment?
I am in the Army. I'm a recruiter currently in Huntington Park Recruiting.
See, I can see that. They take models, sign them up, go out, sign a bunch of young men up. Yeah, everybody in the Army looks like this today. I'm willing to sign my life away. Well, what do you say?
I'd say driving under the influence.
Oh, yes. Parents, try to talk couples out of doing that. It's not a good thing to be driving under the influence.
I will.
Okay, you guys get ready to steal. Name something that parents try to talk young couples out of doing.
Quitting school.
Yeah.
Let me see. Quitting school.
Yeah.
Well, the Navy's gonna try to steal. It's on you, Carlton.
It's on me, huh?
It's on you.
Okay, this is very crucial, you know?
Yes, it is.
Sex!
No! No! That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it.
You know, Carlton, the way you scream and yell, were you ever a drill instructor?
No, but I got three lovely daughters out there. They know the deal.
They know the deal.
Yeah.
They know the deal, what you tell them about.
Oh, that's
you
right.
You say definitely no. Okay, you're still alive if we see no sex.
Oh, wow.
Yes, you are.
Come on, Dale, keep it rolling. Keep it rolling.
Using drugs.
Oh, you got to tell them. You're talking about name something parents try to talk young couples out of doing. Let me see. You're still alive if I see drugs. Listen to the question. Listen to the question. Name something parents try to talk young couples out of doing.
Craig.
Dating.
Dating. Julie.
I don't believe I'm saying this. Joining the military. A lot of parents do that. I know. A lot of parents do, though. It's not right. Not right.
George. Staying out late.
Staying out late. Young couples. Dress.
I'm going to say smoking as a couple.
Smoking as a couple.
it's
think making love is already up there, Russ.
Together kind of thing.
Smoldering smoking. Oh.
Okay. Liz, you can take any of their answers or go out on your own. There are two that will let you steal the bank from the Army that said they were going to sink your ships.
Yep. Well, we'll just have to tell the Army we're going to go with staying out too late.
Couples.
Yeah.
You've taken that. Let me see.
It's there.
Staying out too late. Let me see number three. Going into debt. Number four. Living. Oh, well, we're coming back with a lot more fun, so please don't go away. Come back, you guys.
For thousands inside and out.
We're back. We're going to $300. The Army has $142. The Navy has zero. We go, George, with another face-off. Good luck. The dollar value is doubled. The Navy needs this before the ship is sunk. The top five answers are on the board. Here we go. Name something with wooden legs. Ron.
A table.
Let me see a table.
Yeah.
It is number one.
Yeah.
Alvinia. The
yes.
Lovely Alvinia.
Hi.
How are you? What do you
I'm
say?
I'm bubbling. A chair.
Let me see a chair.
How you doing?
Fine. What do you say?
A couch.
Let me see. Maybe a couch.
Come on.
Little hope for the Navy. Little hope for the Navy. Carlton.
All right. Something with a wooden leg. A stool.
All right.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah.
A stool. Carlton has done his part. Dale, keep it rolling. You can win the game with this question. Something with wooden legs.
Coffee table.
Can we say that, Judge? Is it same thing as a table, Dale? Need another answer.
Baby crib.
A baby crib. Let me see. Baby crib. Maybe you get a chance to steal and be ahead in this game, as Ron can't tell me. Something with wooden legs.
A person.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
You're still alive if we see a person. Here we go, Navy. Name something with wooden legs.
A bench.
A bench.
Yeah.
A bed.
A bed.
Oh, no. George doesn't know.
A dresser.
A dresser. Liz?
Hey, Liz.
You can do whatever you want. Russ has never given a right answer, though. It's up to you.
Dresser.
What would you like
dresser.
To do?
Dresser.
You, yeah. You give me an answer, you're still alive. If you're wrong, the Army will win the game.
Dresser.
What do
dresser.
You say?
Dresser.
It's pressure.
Dresser. Dresser.
We're going to go with a dresser.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
You're in this game if see I see a dresser.
Oh,
Number four. Pinocchio! I gotta say, stay right here. I need two players for $5,000 for the Army Relief Fund. Who's playing first? We'll be right back. Are you playing first?
Yes.
It's Merlin. Don't go away. The Army. Ready?
Settle with annual membership. Call now.
Here we go. You know how it works. I'm going to ask you five questions. You give me the most popular answers that you can think of. You have 15 seconds to give me those answers. When you and your partner pile up 200 or more points, you're going to take home $5,000.
Yeah.
Are you ready? 15 seconds on that clock, please. Good luck. Name an occupation in which you'd need a very steady hand.
Secretary.
How many pets you have?
Two.
Something given up for Lent.
Pass.
Something on the front door of a house.
Doorknob.
Something bees do.
Pollinate.
Something given up for Lent.
Furniture.
Turn around. He said, did you hear Sergeant Tom? Furniture. Well, these Army guys, they'll go...
It's all right, man.
They'll go a long
all right.
way.
That's all right.
For Lent. I think he'll let you have it, but I don't think it really matters, Sergeant. Name an occupation in which you'd need a very steady hand. You said the steady-handed profession of secretaries. Our survey said zero. How many pets you have, you said? You have two pets. Survey said 20. You're on the
hill. All right, baby. On a roll now.
Something that you would give up for Lent, you would give up nothing. Pass, you said. Judge wouldn't even let you have it. Something on the front door of the house, you said. A doorknob. Our survey said 22.
That's
something that bees do, you said. They pollinate. Our survey said.
All right.
We're going to cover those answers. It's not disastrous. We're back with your teammates. Here comes the sergeant. How are you?
How are you? I'm fine. How are you?
Stand right there. Are you ready?
I'm buttoned.
You are?
Yes.
All right, because you're going to have to bring this home.
Okay.
You're going to have to be the cavalry, as a matter of fact, charging in on this one.
I can handle you need... all of them.
All right. I'm going to ask you the same five questions that I asked your partner. If you hear this sound, it means if you win, you're supposed to give me a big military kiss.
Okay.
It means you've duplicated his answer, or I'll say try again, you give me another answer.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
A little more difficult, so 20 seconds on the clock, please. You just listen to these questions and tell me what you think, and I bet you do this. Name an occupation in which you'd need a very steady hand.
Policeman.
How many pets you have?
None.
Something given up for Lent.
Meat.
Something on the front door of a house.
Welcome mat.
Something bees do.
Sting.
Ooh, turn around here. You need 156 points for the $5,000. Name an occupation in which you need a very steady hand. You said? Policeman. I can see that now. Okay, wait a minute. Freeze! All right. Our survey said zero. The number one answer will make a lot of sense. Surgeon, physician, number one.
Okay.
How many pets you have? You said you have none. Our survey said 25. Very nice. One pet was the number one answer.
Okay.
Something given up for Lent. You said meat. Survey said 22, very nice. Candy was the number one answer. Something on the front door of a house. You said? Welcome mat. Our survey said? Only five. Knocker was the number one answer. You're going to probably be going for $5 a point or something that bees do. You said they sting you. Our survey said? 29. Make honey number one. $5 a point you have. $625. Come out here, fellas, and support it. We're going to come right back. Don't go away. That's one point on. Good comeback.
My favorite thing about...
Or order online at getpopandplay.com.
New Jergens, aloe and lanolin, and vitamin E and lanolin soaps. Now bursting with skin-softening ingredients. Carter's Little Pills, with the ingredient doctors recommend. For fast, safe, gentle relief of irregularity, trust Carter's Little Pills. Theragran M, multivitamins with minerals rich in B vitamins that help turn food into energy. Helps unleash energy. Lassie, full season flea and tick collars in bright colors. Lassie collars for dogs and cats. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.